Hello there, and welcome back. I'm Aldrahil, and this is Europa Universalis 4, Aztec Sunset Invasion. We're continuing on. I pretty much started recording straight away from when I left off. We're just going to be finishing this war. We've got the beautiful amount of power projection, and we're going to gain even more from vassalizing our former ones. Da-da-da-da-da. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that, and we're going to vassalize them. That'll give us 13, and we need 13, so it's I have to take both of them. No big deal. Manpower is a little bit low, but that's okay. We're going to wait another year before we do any kind of wars. Unfortunately, the game still has some element of waiting. Ooh! Tadasans declared war on Tadapanek. Very interesting. Wow. Alright, you're gonna accept, yeah? Yeah, we're gonna take that and we're gonna vassalize you. Thanks a bunch. Thanks, hombre. Now, in my previous playthroughs, I always sold Coetlaxlan back to Totanac, but I realized something. Is that Coetlaxlan is the important center of trade, giving it 20 trade power. That's right, 20 trade power. So now, I earn an absolute shit ton through trade. Whoa, what the hell? What? Why do I get so much money? Why the hell do I get 3 point... That's a bug. That has to be a bug. What? 420, smoke weed every day. What? That implies they're getting 31 a month. How on earth are they getting 31 a month? Their armies aren't even here. They're not looting, are they? Good God. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to move our entire army over here, and we're going to straight up core this shit. It's mine now. And our new mission is to claim our rival's province of Coetzee, which is exactly what we're going to do. Thanks, buddy. There's no way that is real. 420. No. It's going to change. Wow! I don't even understand. What's going on? Why is Telepanek have such huge income? I have no idea. Whatever. I'm making a mint from this. Whatever. Alright, let's pick a new rival. We're gonna pick Mixtec. I can annex these guys in another 5 years, so I'm just gonna take that. And I'm gonna... Oh no. They discovered me. That's okay. And I'm going to embargo them. There we go, I'm embargoing 3. So I'm going to lose it soon. That's not too big a deal. What's the revolt risk? 2.6%, and that's going to go down. I don't really want rebellions. Because the new rebellion system is really interestingly different. Now instead of a random chance all the time. Ooh, you know what, I should be lowering my... Oh yeah. Wow, that's a lot of money I'm making. Look at that. I can't believe this is staying. There it goes. Okay, that's steadier. That's a lot steadier. How it works now is instead of a random chance continuously of rebellions, instead you have a percent chance for whether each province will generate if the rebellions are the same. So I only have one province that's doing that, and it's unrest for nationalist rebels, I believe. Yeah, nationalist rebels. So, for Totanac, whatever. So, we suffer 2.3% unrest, and it's going down, because my overextension and war exhaustion is going to go down, so it's not really going to be an issue. But if I did let that continue, and over approximately 75 years, they would revolt, and I would get quite a large rebellion. So now rebellions are more dangerous. Okay. Look at all this. We're making... Okay, now we have faced with an issue. We are making 1.74 monies per month. And that's huge, and it's only going to go up. But I'm going to make the decision once the core is done. Do I hire a diplomatic advisor? It may be a good idea. Because if I do, I will gain additional diplo power, but I want the money. I need the money. You know? Very tricky. What province are they trying to claim, anyway? Ah, they're trying to claim that one. Oh, for them, wow. Oh my. That's not good. I wish I got a positive stability event, that'd be nice. There we go. We're getting the conquest CB. And I don't want me to take it. I will do that. There we go. We'll improve relation with our buddies. Our little vassal pals. There we go. Unrest is basically a non-factor now. Let's see how much more money I get when the core is finished, and then I'll decide what to do about wars and such. It's on 1.21, so no taxation because of autonomy. Ooh, additional manpower, how kind of you. Wow, look at all that war. Oh man. That's not good. Alright. It's now still 1.23, let's leave it the month to change. 2.16, very good. So if I decrease autonomy to gain the additional money, it is going to cause quite a lot of rebellions, so I'm not going to do that. Yeah, I'm not going to do that. So my monthly is 1.89. And with full manpower it's 1.17, so I wouldn't really be making any money. Wow, that's huge. That's a lot of men. What we're going to do now is we are going to declare war on Tarasan. And how that's going to work is we're going to declare war on Tarasan. Some money making, fair enough. And, Tricky. I might just be able to get away with just one vassal. And we're going to humiliate and get war reparations from Mixtec, and we're going to vassalize. Oh, we can't! No! We're not able to vassalize Tarasan because they have too many provinces now. That sucks. Alright, let's just get to it then. We better do this fast. Oh shit, military coalition. Another ship? Zamatek won't join? Are you serious? Bruh. Who can Mixtec call in? Oh my god, everybody. So we're not gonna call Mixtec in as an ally, we're gonna call in Kalima. One more month. Alright, this is gonna be a really harsh war. Stick to allies, my friends. Alright, let's do it. Take Koitsa. Let's do it. Crush him. So can I vassalize these guys? We'll find out in a sec. Can't believe they won't join me. You suck, Zapotec. Alright, so can I do that? Oh, I can still vassalize them. Excellent. That'd be pretty cool. How would I get to Lepenek, though? Very tricky. Oh, what you gonna do? We're coming for you. Yeah. There we go. And now we're gonna set them to independently siege. That way, they will automatically do as I ask. Now we're gonna very quickly crush the remaining army. One war, basically won already. What you doing? We don't appreciate that. It's not appreciated. It's just not. No. Start to get our first sieges done soon. Fantastic. Awesome. And we will lower the army maintenance so we can continue to rake in the mad cash. Trade power we have. It's huge. It's very nice. Plenty of sieges finished. I will accept the unrest. Yeah, I'll accept the unrest. God, I love the music in this. Very nice. Alright. I would like you to be humiliated and to give me war reparations. Thank you, goodbye. And to remove your alliance with Yitzhak. Fantastic. Oh, 90 power projection. Beautiful. And for Tarasan, you will give me that. You will give me Koitsu, and you will give me a vassal. That's all I need. That's all I need. Fantastic. Look at that. Oh no. I will dissolve my alliance with Colima. 100 power projection. Freaking fantastic. I have no need for Koito. It gives me barely anything, so I'll just sell it back to them. But I will claim our rival's province. There we are, Koit Lachakakakaka. And I will revoke the embargo. Oops, I forgot. I need to call in that. I will revoke the embargo on Tarasan, because they're my vassals now. And I will sell them Koitsu. Fantastic. And there we have it. And because I now have 2.38, I'm definitely going to get the first advisor. Get that. Do I still have the relevant three rivals? Oh, no, I don't. Mixtec and Telepanek. I'll put Kalima as the next. There we are. Then we shall have another year of peace. Actually, 3 years of peace. Because then I want to start annexing Tlaxcala. And once Tlaxcala is the annexation process has begun, we will start with the ever lovely Mixtec and crush them horribly. Take that province and then feed the other one to Tarasan. Make a claim on. Oh, I can't make a claim on. Oh, Tarasan has a claim! Excellent. Then I'll just take it and then give the rest to Tarasan. Beautiful. This is working out fantastically. Now, in 2 years, once the heir is in charge, what I'll do is I'll make him king. General, sorry. And I will try and get him killed, because I do not want him alive. Oh shit, my Jenga's still in the charge. Oh my god. That could have been bad. That could have been really bad. Never, ever have your king as Aztecs in charge, because it's so possible he could die. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do, I'll stop the recording here, and it's going to be 3 years of peace. I'm going to cut out just waiting, and essentially what we're going to be doing is waiting. And once the annexation process has begun for Tlaxcala, we will begin our little war with Mixtec. So I was Aljo and I continue to be, and this has been European Resource 4, Aztec Sunset Invasion. Thank you very much for watching.